Pascal Rambert, abbiamo visto Le Clôture de l'Amour, uno spettacolo che già da qualche tempo girava in Italia con grande successo, con una straordinaria presenza di due attori, Luca Lazzareschi e Anna Della Rosa, e già sta girando il nuovo spettacolo, La Prova. Del lavoro naturalmente parleremo, ma sono tante le suggestioni che sono venute dallo spettacolo che abbiamo visto. E la prima che mi è venuta in mente e che vorrei chiederti è proprio un possibile collegamento tra due mondi molto francesi, molto diversi, che sono quelli di Jacques Lacan e di Antonin Artaud. Non so se questi possono essere punti di riferimento nella tua ricerca, ma insomma, la mente come linguaggio, la violenza del linguaggio, la violenza del corpo, un teatro estremamente crudele anche nell'apparente immobilità dell'interprete, degli attori, mi ha fatto pensare a questi due Moloch della cultura francese. Ti interessano oppure no?
When I write, I don't write with references. Yes, I try to avoid that. I don't do psychoanalysis, so it's not something that I do in my life. Okay. Yes, as everyone, I know a few things about Lacan when I at least can understand what is going on in the writing. I don't do references. Mm. So in your question, in this case, if I do something a little bit from Lacan, it's to fight the law.
E allora ecco, non fa riferimenti, ma come sono nati questi testi, come lavora abitualmente, qual è l'idea iniziale, qual è lo spunto iniziale, non so quanto c'è di autobiografico nelle dinamiche che lei racconta.
It's easy. Usually because I have like 1 or 3 years before the next play that I have to write, so I need a lot of time first to prepare the brain, prepare everything to be completely with a long time in front of me, and after I start to write pretty quite quickly. Like I wrote Clôture de l'amour in 3 weeks because the thing is completely inside of my body, and so I know, and I'm writing for actors. So when I'm going to choose, for instance, the French actors, this is the way I write. I'm not like a writer in his room thinking of a theater piece. I know exactly which body I'm going to put the words in. And so this is really something about like an energetic moment. So that's why there is no references. For me, the thing to write is to avoid all the things that usually make stop something which comes from the unconscious place, you know? So instead of building things, I try to open up in order that the thing goes like that. That's how I see it. But for Clôture de l'amour, it was so clear that the bodies of Stanislas Nordet and Audrey Bonnet were, and the tone of the voice, the tessiture, the inflection of the back of Audrey, the way to speak with the hands of, so it's something which is really like basically quite easy to do because I have those people in front of me and I take like a snake or like an eagle, you know, their skin.
È molto bello questo gesto. Io vado investigando con i laboratoristi, no? Chiedo loro cosa fanno, come lavorano con i maestri. E i laboratoristi di Pascal Rambert mi hanno fatto tutti questo gesto di slancio, di presa, no? È molto, molto fisico. E questo appunto mi dà il là per chiederle proprio che cos'è per lei un laboratorio, come sta lavorando in questo workshop.
I hate workshop and things like that, so I never do that. I think it's just it's annoying. But I came here and I said yes to Alex when he invited me because it's him and also it's the Biennale and the space is very important. To be in a space which is where there is kind of like vast possibilities for the look, the time inside, and the physical actions. But it's very difficult actually to explain what we do. It's even if I'm a writer, it's I try to not put words on things. For instance, since a week I try to speak as less as possible, because what we did here, what we are doing now, it's not like my work. I'm not trying to do something with those 5, 7, 18 beautiful people with who I'm working right now, but at least to give back to them the possibility that Alex gave me, to have a frame for people to find inside this frame their own freedom for their own work, and doing that in real time, 18 together. Mm-hmm. See, it's not easy to say. Huh? It's not easy to explain exactly what we are doing. Mm. And because we are writing, we spend 2 hours writing in a silence. It's beautiful to, for me, it's like a pleasure to look at people writing by their own in a shadow or in the sun. It's beautiful. In silence like that. And after we start to try to find a form as much as we can. Sometimes it's really awful. Sometimes it's really beautiful. And so that does like that. But I prefer all the time what I see in front of me, things that I didn't decide, rather than to see something that I decided. So I prefer the upcoming reality in front of me in performing art, rather than fix things which are totally fixed. And I can't stand anymore the fixed things. For instance, what you saw in Clôture de l'Amour, there is like 2 positions, and after they are in real time also. They can do exactly what they want with the scores that they have. But it's not like, I'm not a director who says, oh, can you open the door, take this chair and sit and talk? I can't work like that anymore. It's not possible for me. It's the death of theater.
Parlava degli attori, i suoi attori di riferimento. Stanislas Nordet, naturalmente, La Bonnet, sono stati appunto 2 attori feticcio, no, con cui ha lavorato. Però questi suoi testi poi hanno avuto ed hanno edizioni transnazionali. Spagna, Italia. Cosa cambia il rapporto con gli attori? Come cambia? E con la lingua, naturalmente.
For instance, I did 10 versions. I directed 10 versions all over the world of Clôture de l'Amour in New York, Moscow, Italy, Zagreb, Hamburg, Tokyo, Denmark, but whatever, and Spain, of course, last summer. And the last one I just did was in Pechino. And so, but of course, in the Latin language, that could be okay, but it is not as okay that we think. But the thing is, like, for instance, I spend a lot of time with the translators and the actors around the table in order to jump from the translation to something which can be said on stage, okay? So that the thing can go really inside the mouth of the actors and inside the body. If not, we are just like saying a dead text. So we need to do all this work for weeks in order that the actor can privatize completely the text for themselves. Once this thing is done, I leave, and they have 2 months to learn the text, for instance, for Clôture de l'amour, but it was the same process for Prova that we just did in Italy. And after I come back, and after we start to, we do, like what was here, we do it once a day, the full text, and I don't speak. But they do it exactly like a real thing. They come on stage in this kind of like set, they do it. It's like something which is totally organic, where the words are like inside another one, another one, another one, and that produces a kind of like a loop of energy. In the organicity of the writing, this is also something that I try to reach, this kind of like strength of time inside the world that I'm choosing, which is usually called a play, a theater play. But this kind of energy is for me very, it's like atomic inside the thing. Sometimes I succeed, sometimes not at all, but this is a game.
Vorrei tornare però alla suggestione iniziale, no? Dalla pratica quotidiana della scrittura. Lei ci ha detto che Clôture de l'amour è stato scritto molto in fretta, pensando a questi attori. Ma ecco, qual è il lavoro quotidiano? Martin Krimp ci diceva che scrive a mano. Lei come lavora? Dove lavora? Qual è lo spazio in cui lavora e qual è il tempo in cui lavora?
For me to write is a pleasure and at the same time like the worst thing that I have to do every day. So this is something that, at the same time that I fear and something that I desire secretly every day. So my life is organized this way. I do yoga very early in the morning. And after I start to write for 2 or 3 hours, it's really a lot, so 2 hours. And after I go to rehearsal in every single country where I am, and at night I go to see theater abroad. Because I love to go to theater. I love to watch theater, everything, every kind of theater, everything. I need to see theater. It's like a disease. It's an addiction for me to go and see performers. And I do the same thing the day after, like that, every day. So it's not exactly funny. I'm not like a funny guy, but this is the life I choose. And I really do like that, and I write everywhere. I don't want to be like a writer with my little pencils, and I want to write everywhere. I want to write in trains, in planes, waiting for, I don't know, the metro or something like that. I don't want to be stuck in a position of the writer. I want to be, that my body could be inside the flow of the life that I have day after day. So I don't want to stop the reality. I try, in the contrary, to jump in the flow of the stream of the life.
Molto bello questo. E che lingua parlano i suoi personaggi? Come sceglie la lingua dei suoi personaggi?
I was listening to Martin Krimp the other day, and I really admire him. But I could see how different the things are, and the way to treat writing, everyday writing, is different for everybody. And I have the feeling that I don't write. You know, I don't think I'm a writer. And this thing, I can't do that when you have to fill up your passport. It's like something that I can't put the word writer, director. It's something which is, I have some problem with that. But still, it's, I try to be a mouth of something which goes like that, but I don't have the feeling that I'm writing. That goes out of me like that when I'm typing or, but it's not like if I was like, I'm gonna write. No, it's totally something like a dance, you know? Like a body dance, something which is totally like, which goes like a spring. So I let it go. And after I organize, yes, like an eagle, the words. So after I, I rewrite and I put the architecture of the thing. But the first movement is this, just to listen. And we always say to actors, can you please listen? And the first work of a writer is to listen first. And it's because we listen and we give this kind of like voice to this voice that after actors can take them and... Voilà. So it's a process of, it's like a continuum of listening. The writing is a continuum process of listening, I think.
E per questo non c'è molta differenza anche nel suo percorso di teatro danza. Lei ha creato anche delle coreografie, degli spettacoli danzati dove il corpo è primario.
Yes, because I think it's exactly the same thing. It's a question of language. I work on language. For me, Clôture de l'amour, okay, it's a breakup, whatever, but it's first of all, it's like levels of language, layers of people who are speaking in a certain way, people who are speaking a little bit upper, and so on, and things that I hear and that I throw back to my own time. Oh. But for me, it's exactly the same thing. When I created the show in Avignon, in Avignon Festival in 2011 of Clôture de l'amour, I was always saying that for me it was like a dance piece. And of course it's like 2 hours of talk. But for me it's really a dance piece. No. It's really a dance piece because the words give the form to the body. And it's not just like you are going to roll here and after do that and raise your arm. It is the text which gives from the inside the organicity of the movement. And for me this is... a way to show how we have so many like boundaries in our head. What is dance, what is theater, and I'm doing that since almost now 40 years, and I still really don't know. And I'm amazed when I hear people saying this is that, because me, I really don't know. Mm. I love the art of theater. I gave my life to the art of theater, and I will continue to do that till I die. With no intermission, because this is something which is really, this is fantastic, because at the same time you are all by yourself, and after you have like with a bunch of people, and after there is more people, usually we call that the audience, and so on. So it's like it's a wonderful energy between human beings, and I like that. I must admit, I love that. I love this moment.
Ed è per questo che nei suoi spettacoli è forte una prospettiva metateatrale, no? In qualche modo lei parla di attori o di artisti colti nel momento in cui stanno per creare. Uno storico del teatro italiano diceva che l'attore è l'animale più simile all'uomo. E in qualche modo lei fa anche una antropologia dell'attore e dell'attrice, ce li spiega nei loro sentimenti, che forse sono sempre un po' diversi da quelli della specie umana.
Yes and no. What, because I have this amazing chance to work in so many different languages all over the world, so I'm more than maybe doing theater, I have the feeling more to deal every day with geopolitics. Because when you do theater, I don't know, in Cairo or I don't know, in China or whatever, in so different country, at a certain point, after 2 or 3 days, you hit the point of politics, of what is going on in the world. And this is beautiful for that also, because it's very, very rich. And but for me, it's like I've seen so many different ways of acting, especially, I don't know, like when I was working in Moscow, in the Art Moscow Theater, they have really like a way to work in France, of course, in Italy. And this gives me a lot of like knowledge about what humanity is. And when we think that we are so different, me, I don't see that. Okay. I see that we are very similar.
Questo ci fa parlare anche di un altro argomento che volevo toccare, il ruolo politico, la responsabilità politica dell'artista in questo momento, in questa società, è un tema che ha già affrontato e che si riverbera anche nella sua direzione di un teatro importante come quello di Gennevilliers. Allora, come vive questo ruolo?
Exactly the same way that I'm talking now, or I'm doing the workshop, or I write, I try to be in the present. So I decided for those 10 past years and that I direct this theater in Paris, in Gennevilliers, to be in the present and to just do like artists who are live. So I never like invited anybody to do Shakespeare or to do Molière or something like that. It's just like live artists. And more or less people who are creating their own world and own work. And so for me it was a way to continue to follow this listening to the world in which I live. So I was not in as a director, but more like a writer. I think to direct a theater is to continue to be a writer in a way that all the artists that I invited among like 200 were like really like carefully chosen and perfectly, I hope, welcome and well contexted in the full season to try to have a kind of identity. For me to have this theater was exactly like to have like a library where you have the books you love. So I invited the artist I loved. And never considering that, the audience won't like that, I can't do that for my audience, the audience is not ready for that. I've heard so much and so many people saying that, you know, when you are an artist, it's quite kind of like hard work, we can't present that, you know. It's really annoying, and it's true, by the way. Because we can do everything we want, and when it's really like centered, the audience follows. And finally, I took a theater which was a kind of like oldish and like with not a lot of people coming to it. And now it's something which is almost bright new with a young generation, mixed people also, because we can't just be like well-educated white man of 50. So we need to be with like that the people who are in our theater are like the society also where we are living in. And right now we have a lot of problems in theaters because, and it's really like all about Europe. Huh? And I tried to do what I could do to try to open up the theater in order that, this is a very simple gesture, but that requires a very, very long work to do that. But that goes with the society. We need with the society also to do it. This is a way to answer to the reality also, through fiction and spaces like that.
Ma la realtà se ne rende conto, nel suo caso sì, in Italia molto meno. C'è una risposta effettiva, c'è una possibilità per il teatro di incidere concretamente nel reale?
I believe in it. I believe that, yes. Maybe I'm totally naive, but how can I put it? Theater changed my life, so I think this is possible for some other people, of course. And I work for that. Sometimes, if there is, I don't know, somebody, someone of 20 in the audience, and suddenly this thing is going to... Maybe we work for that. We work for... For me, I think that theater is... as art is like is a road of emancipation. So we are here, and what we do since a week, it's exactly the same thing. I'm not in a judgment, saying like, I've seen that a million times, I know this kind of work, blah blah blah. We try to give away here and in other places to give away to a kind of emancipation, yes. So I think that can change.
Grazie. Passo la parola a voi, alle vostre domande.
Good afternoon. I have a question around the piece that we saw, La Clôture de l'amour. I would like to know, what's the role of the audience, and or better, what do you expect from the audience to receive from a piece like that? Because it was very intimate and very specific, and so the audience was really outside all of that. Just we were just looking at something. So it was, for me, it was interesting to see myself there watching this and find, oh, why am I watching something so private? And just a second question, might be a bit naive, but I didn't understand the final hat with the wings. Thank you.
Thank you. I don't know. I don't know. I can't tell what I what I'm waiting from. No, I have no expectation at all. I don't know. When I write, I'm not thinking like, oh, I'm going to produce that on the audience, you know? I don't want to, me, I like what I don't understand. For example, I like to go to theater and to see theater like abroad with no subtitles, and when I don't get it, I can start to work. So I can't, I will be working for, I'm kidding, but I will be working for Broadway if I wanted to have an effect on people. It's really not something that I'm thinking of at all. I give those objects to be seen, but I feel very responsible for it, but I have no aim, like, you should be happy, you should cry, you should be, no, I don't know, I really don't know. And for the question of the feathers, I made a vow to never answer to this question, so. Since, 7 years, I don't answer to this question, so it's okay. And I keep my, I'm very serious on that.
Quindi è una domanda frequente, insomma, sta a noi la libera interpretazione del copricapo. Una domanda volevo far aggiungerla io. Il workshop è dedicato alle annunciazioni. Perché? Cosa sono?
No, because I've been working quite a lot this past year in Italy, and so after yoga, after writing, after rehearsing, I go to see art, and just like raise your head, and you see all those beautiful things here in this country, which is so great. Italy is really great. Yeah. And... yes, and I was looking at those annunciations, and I really liked how the la parola materialized like that on certain annunciations with golden, and sometimes there is some word like that on a kind of like ribbon like that. I wanted to try to put some new words to announce some new things for the new times without being pretentious, but just to put some new words into old forms. The theater is a very old, beautiful form, and every day of my life I'm trying to re-question that and more or less try to find something which is alive, which is finally the only aim, the only goal, to try to find something alive, which is not always the case. This is a work of theater, so this is like that. We have to understand that it's something that we barely never really succeed in the beauty that we are looking for, and so those kind of annunciation was a way to also to put some words for people to know where they were going to put their feet in this workshop with me, to have an idea that, and for instance, we are 7 or 8 different languages working all together, nationalities, and we try really to keep our language and the way we talk in our own mother language in order to really like keep the strong meaning of the things out and to let the poetical listening of somebody else when we don't understand another language to make up our own stories by listening. And this is really great. I love that.
I just wondered, since you said you staged the play at least 7 times in 7 different countries.
10.
10, okay. And did you always use the same scenery for the staging? And did it give different endings? Because I somehow felt that there would have been a lot different possibilities in the end. And did the actors and actresses have the possibility to do slight text changes, or did they always stay on stage for throughout the whole text?
Yes. In Beijing, almost everywhere, it's not always the same set, because I change the set. Most of the time, I love to change a set and to recreate something different, but it's always more or less like kind of like true theater, empty theater, un palcoscenico, voilà, empty, or like a place where you understand that it's a public place. It's not like intimate, like a bedroom or something like that. That's why here it's kind of like dance place where you can do dance. You know, there were some dance bars like that. The very true different is in Moscow, because they still continue to perform. I directed in Moscow in 2012, and they continue to perform every time. So it's like since almost like four years now they are doing that. And they asked me recently the right to continue till 2018. And I went in Moscow last year, and the thing was really changed. Because there is nothing we can do against Russian actors. They are very tough, and they took the shit out of me when I was in Moscow. Yes, because they are very like strong actors. Like I work with very, very, very high level actors, but those one are really like Russian. And I loved it, and I love them, but they change the text every night, and I'm like, come on guys, write your play. If you think that it's not good enough for you, write your own Clôture de l'amour. It's okay, you know, I'm not going to ask you any like fees and things like that. They change, they smoke on stage, I don't know, it's like, but I do love them, and I to answer your question, I love when it's, I think like a text is meant to be betrayed, being like violated, changed, not respected at all. Right now there is tomorrow, I guess, the opening of Clôture de l'amour that I don't direct in Rio, and I've seen some pictures. I prefer not to go and see it, you know. But it's okay. It's like a piece of flesh, and it's okay that the thing has to be alive in other hands. That doesn't belong to me, and I'm really not. I hate, for instance, two days ago when Martin Krim was speaking about Beckett. I know that Beckett was very like, and the right, the people who own the right of Beckett's, you can't do everything you want on that. I exactly think the contrary. I think a text should be like given, and that everybody could do whatever he wants with it in every on the head, like we are doing in the 70s, naked maybe. And if we do art, it's not to stay on our little chair and be shy. Everything is possible. So for me, the texts are meant to be field.
Come avviene per i classici.
As it happens. I don't know this word in Italian, what?
Classic, the classical text.
I guess, I don't know, for maybe Shakespeare has been done in so many ways that this is the quality of that. Mm. Because this is an interpretation, the art of theater is interpretation, so we interpret. We have something and we put a kind of interpretation. Sometimes the interpretation are interesting, sometimes not. But this is interpretation. Mm. And it's beautiful to see people interpret an object.
As a writer, writer for theater, I suppose you love writing, but you love also reading. So I would like to know which is your relationship with reading, and in particular with poetry, pure poetry.
So. It's going to be like, But I basically read poetry and philosophy. That's why I apologize to answer such answers, okay? But this is true, this is what I like. I love to read poetry. I think poetry is the best thing in the world. I think the people who are running the world are poets, and certainly not the other one. For me, the highest level of are poets. I have a huge admiration for poets, and because now it's hard, it's not like a big thing to read poetry, because, you know, for the publishing house, it's difficult to sell poetry, so it's difficult to follow what is going on in contemporary, but I try to do it. I really enjoy that. And also philosophy, yes. Especially analytic philosophy. Very hard and very mean and not funny. But it's really good. It's like that, it's a way to clean up the brain for me. To read philosophy, it's like, to clean up the brain inside.
Altra domanda?
Mi spiace, forse non ho visto lo spettacolo, quindi non vorrei porre una domanda a sproposito, ma siccome sento che lei è uno scrittore e che il discorso della lingua è molto importante, il peso delle parole, il titolo che lei ha lasciato in francese e in italiano, domando se lo ha lasciato in francese anche negli altri paesi, perché clôture in francese significa varie cose e quindi da un lato può essere la fine di un amore, la cessazione di un amore, ma significa anche un ambiente chiuso, un perimetro chiuso, e questo si riallaccia alla domanda della signora, per cui il pubblico può rimanere estraneo a un'intimità che però è un luogo limitato. Ecco, intendevo che desideravo una spiegazione da parte sua.
You said it all. You said it. It's exactly that, and it's exactly that. But you know, when I wrote the play, 7 or 8 years ago, I don't know. When I thought about clôture and writing this play, I thought it was a play which was like done with love. It was a way to say, okay, love is done, no more. Okay. But I think it's not that. I think it's exactly the contrary. In the world of clôture, it's a way to take care. When you put like a sheep inside the clôture, it's because you don't want the wolf comes and eat the sheep. And finally, I found out that this kind of like clôture was a way to preserve love. And I think that clôture de l'amour is not a, now I understand it better, is not like a play which was on a breakup, but instead of that, on the power of a very strong love between those two persons. And usually we think something and we do the contrary. Here we are. And clôture de l'amour in French, because we couldn't, I guess, really find the perfect Translation in Italian. Closto.
Chiusura.
No. Was for me too much Catholic or something like that. I couldn't handle that for sure. And in French, clôture, it's like clôture of the, you know, when you close your shop at night at 7 or something. In English, I did it like love's end, like dead's end, like kind of like, so sometimes that works, sometimes that doesn't work. In Japanese, it's completely something different, in Chinese also, so it's, each time we try to get to the, but it's very difficult. And because we thought that Italian people knew a little bit of French, that will be tricky to keep it like that.
Ci affascina sempre un po'. Un'ultima domanda, se l'abbiamo, qui davanti.
Buongiorno. innanzitutto, vabbè, ringrazio ovviamente la tua presenza qui. Io faccio parte dell'Accademia Palcoscenico del Teatro Stabile del Veneto e il nostro direttore ha chiamato Luca Lazzareschi per lavorare con noi e lui ci ha portato Clôture de l'amour e abbiamo lavorato sul testo per un mesetto.
For one month?
One month.
Un mese, sì. E infatti è stata una sorta di immersione, un'immersione poi ci ha tirato fuori, va bene, e alcuni sì, sono stati tirati fuori, altri invece ci sono rimasti dentro, va bene, e io devo ancora capire se sono
dentro fuori.
Sì, dentro o fuori, ma comunque mi ha cambiato molto a livello dell'ascolto, perché si recita, va bene, per 40 minuti, però poi altri 40 minuti in cui ascolti, va bene? Ed è come se il teatro fosse stato ridotto alla parola e ascolto, va bene? Ed è stato eccezionale esplodere attraverso il testo e aprirsi al pubblico. Volevo chiederti quanto c'è di liberatorio da parte tua, quanto c'è stato di liberatorio da parte tua nella scrittura di questo testo, che ho letto che è anche parzialmente autobiografico, e cosa provi quando lo vedi, lo guardi?
First of all, I'm fed up to watch it. I've seen it too many times and I can't look at Clôture de l'amour anymore. It's really like, it's difficult for me. And I perform also in French, the guy part, so it's enough now. It's time for me to, but I've been doing a lot of different shows since Clôture de l'amour, of course, and I have a lot in front of me to do, but so for me it's kind of like old show already. But but the freedom I put, it's a total freedom, it's what I was saying before. I don't know if we are completely free, of course not. Of course I live with the bodies that I have, the education that I have, and okay. But I try to avoid that as much as I can. It's something which is, for me, and I love simplicity, by the way. There is nothing more that I love in theater that maybe the best thing I love will be like empty space, like here, like where we were, like where we are actually in Salle d'Armes. The daily light, a naked body, and maybe somebody talking. I think this is the start of the theater. Something which is, and to do that, and to be in the life, not to do fake things, which is so difficult. This is what I enjoy every day. I try. I'm fed up. It's okay, but I'm not for video on stage and, you know, and big lights. I don't care. It's like technique makes me puke. It's not like the thing which is nice is to arrive to the center of something that we all share, which is like this kind of like common thing, all together thing. And if we can do that at the theater, sometimes that happens. A ray of light, a beautiful person, a guy or a girl, it's enough for me. I love when it's simple, when there is not all those things around, I need simplicity a lot, and silence.
Mi sembra che questa sia una bellissima conclusione per il per
il
nostro...
Can I say something?
Oh, please.
After this silent thing, I wanted to thank Alex.
Okay, for
sure. And I wanted to thank Alex for all the work that he has been doing here for 7 years, and to have welcomed us, and that... This is wonderful to be able for me to meet Martin Krim, to see yesterday night, to spend time with Stefan Kaegi and all those people who are like amazing artists. And if we can, I want to if we can, thank you. Thank you, Alex.
Un meritato applauso per il nostro direttore. Allora, grazie a Pascal Rambert, un applauso anche per Pascal Rambert. Appuntamento a domani con Roger Bernat. Grazie a voi.